Hello guys, welcome to SKADEMICUS. Today I'll be explaining the basic design criteria for designing of liquid retaining structures. So in the liquid retaining structures, we have the common liquid retaining structure is the water tank. So water tank are mostly they are RCC water tank and steel water tanks. So in this lecture I'll be discussing about the RCC water tank, which will be designed as per IS 3370. The code has four parts, part 1 to part 4. So the code for practice of the code of practice for the design of storage of liquids is IS 3370 part 1 to part 4. So the storage tanks are built for storing water, liquid petroleum, petroleum products and similar liquids. So any kind of liquids which need to be stored, these need to be designed as per this code IS 3370, that is Indian standard. So the design are that they are designed as a crack free structures, because we are retaining liquid in those structures, so it should be a crack free structures to eliminate any leakages. So let's proceed with a explanation of design of RCC water tank. So RCC water tank, basically it is differentiated into categories. The categories are the based on placement of tank, like your placement, your tank is underground, resting on the soil, or elevated water tank. And then we have the water tank design based on the shape of tank. So we have circular shape water tank, we have rectangular, spherical, conical bottom. So these are the types of water tank which we will be designing in our day-to-day life. So as per the requirement, if we have been asked to design the water tank based on placement, so whether it is a resting on ground, whether it is underground water tank or elevated water tank. So the design criteria in each type is different, because if you design the water tank based on your placement, then resting, if the water tank is resting on ground, so there is no earth pressure exerted on the vertical wall of the water tank. So the design criteria of underground water tank and the resting on ground water tank is totally different. Then comes your elevated water tank. So elevated water tank, basically it is on higher elevation, so the effect of wind will be very high on those types of water tank. Again, if we are designing a water tank based on the geometry, then let's talk about the type of circular water tank and rectangular water tank. So in a circular water tank, we have the hoop stresses developed due to the circumference. So that hoop stresses, and in rectangular water tank there is a simple water pressure. So the force, the pressure exerted by that hoop stress and your simple water pressure, that is different. So the design will depend on those two parameters. So these were the very few basic concepts regarding your types of water tank. So while designing water tank, few things should be kept in mind, few very important things, like the cement content of the water tank should be ranging from 330 kg per meter cube to 530 kg per meter cube. This is the recommended figure of cement content in your water, concrete of water tank. The content is maintained between these two figures, because to keep the shrinkage of concrete in check, that is the shrinkage should be low. And while designing the water tank, we should also keep in mind that we should the high strength deformed bars are basically suggested for design of water tank, but in some cases we can also go for mild steels. But again, the recommendation for the high strength deformed bars are better. Then comes the allowable stresses in reinforcing steels is as per IS 3370. As I already told, that the design criteria for water tank is based on IS 3370, which has four parts. Part 1 to part
for
We will be looking into few problems, few design problems of water tank. So based on the geometry, we'll be dealing with circular water tank, and we'll be designing a square and or a rectangular water tank. So in this lecture, I'll be explaining the circular type of water tank. So water tank are basically they are flexible, and it is also again differentiated into two categories, that is a flexible and rigid base. So if your water tank is resting on ground and it has a flexible base, when the base is flexible, hydrostatic pressure induces maximum increase in diameter at the base. So if you have a flexible base, then the hydrostatic pressure is maximum at base and it will reduce to zero at the top. So this is due to the fact that hydrostatic pressure varies linearly from zero at top and maximum at base. So the deflected shape, this deflected shape is will make you very clear about the hydrostatic pressure of your flexible base water tank. Let's talk about the rigid base. Rigid base, we can see that the deflected shape, that there is no deflection because this is a rigid base, whereas in flexible base water tank, the deflection is like this. So this was regarding your type of water tank based on your rigidity of your at your base and flexibility at your base. So now let's move on to the first type of water tank. That design a circular water tank with flexible connection. Like we are designing a water tank with flexible base. So this type of water tank we are designing. So at base, the capacity of water tank is 4 lakh liters. The tank that is 400 cubic meter. The tank rests on a firm level ground. That is, the water tank type is resting on ground. This is not underground water tank. So the height of a tank including a free board of 200 mm. So in the problem, we have been asked to keep a free board of 200 mm. The height should not exceed 3.5 meter. The tank is open at top. Use M20. So the grade of concrete which we are using is M20 grade of concrete, and grade of steel is Fe415. So we have to draw that plan and cross section through center. So let's move into the first step of design of water tanks. So first, while designing any liquid retaining structure, first we need to work out the geometry of that water tank or liquid retaining structures. So we have been asked the problem that the height of the water tank should not exceed 3.5. So we have considered 3.5, where 0.2 meter is the free board. So the effective depth of water we are getting 3.3 meter. The volume is 400 meter cube. So the area of tank, is volume divided by your height. So this is your volume and divided by height. So we are getting an area of 121.2 meter square. So the diameter is, we have pi d square by 4. So by work with that formula, we are getting d is equals to 12.42. So which is approximately equals to, we are keeping our approximate diameter of water tank as 13 meter. The thickness is assumed as 30 times height plus 50. That is, 30 times height is 3.3. So 3.3 into 30 plus 50 is 149. So which is equals to, we are keeping a thick, the thickness is, the effective thickness is 160 mm. So now let's design the start with the design of vertical wall. So as I have said, there is a hoop tension in a circular water tank. So the maximum hoop tension will be at bottom and minimum will be at top. So because of this maximum and minimum variation of hoop tension, if there we will get a benefit of curtailing that the hoop bar hoop tension bar, we can curtail the hoop tension bar, we can curtail it at the top, since the stresses, the hoop stresses at top is less and bottom is maximum. So the formula for calculation of hoop stress, that the hoop tension T is equals to gamma H D by 2. Gamma is your density of water or liquid, H is the height of water tank, D is the diameter by 2. So the total hoop tension coming is 214.5 kilonewton. The area of steel is equals to T divided by, that is high, the your hoop tension divided by sigma ST. Sigma ST is 150, which is coming from your IS 3370 for Fe415. So the area of steel is coming around 430 mm square. So the main, the reinforcement in the hoop, for the hoop tension is 430 mm. So now we have to also provide a minimum reinforcement at the outer edge, outer surface of the vertical bar. So the minimum reinforcement, the minimum steel criteria, AST minimum is 0.24% of area of concrete. So 0.24 into 1000. 1000 is the 1 meter strip we are considering for design. T is the thickness divided by 100. 100 is because it is 0.24%. So the area of steel, minimum area of steel is 384 mm square. The steel required is more than the minimum required. Let the diameter of bar be. So we are using a 16 mm dia bar. The area of single 16 mm dia bar is 201 mm square. So the spacing of 16 mm dia bar is the AST. AST was 1430 divided by 210 into 1000. 1000 is because we are using a 1 meter strip for design. So the spacing is coming around 140.6 mm per center to center. So we are providing the lesser value, that is 140. Provide 16 mm dia bar at 140 center to center as hoop tension steel. So this steel we are providing is for hoop tension steel, which we can curtail further because the hoop tension at top is less. So we can optimize the reinforcement in the top part of your vertical wall. So now let's move to the next step, step number 3, where we are checking for tensile stress. The area of steel provided, now we have already provided steel. So the exact area of steel provided is coming with the spacing. Exact spacing we have provided 140, whereas it was coming 140.6. So the area, the revised area of steel provided is 1436.16 mm square. So the modular ratio M is equals to 280 by 3 sigma CBC. Sigma CBC was 7 for your concrete. So 280 by 3 into 7. So sigma CBC is 7 for your M20 grade of concrete. Sigma CBC is 7 for M20 grade of concrete. Sigma CBC is basically 2 by 3 of your grade of concrete. So 2 by 3 of 20, it is coming around 7. So the stress in concrete is equals to sigma C is equals to your tension, the total tension divided by 1000, T is thickness, M is your modular ratio, minus 1 AST. So it is coming around 1.2 Newton per mm square. So the permissible stress, that is sigma cat, is equals to 0.27 under root FCK. This is coming from the IS 3370. So the permissible stress is 1.2 and we are getting the actual stress is 1.2. So this should be lesser than or equal to this. So in this case we have an equal value, so we can consider it as a safe design. But generally we need to have the permissible stress should be greater than actual stress, then your design is safe. In this case we have equal permissible as well as actual stress, so then also it is safe. If it is more, then we have to revise. So now let's move to the next point. As I have said, the hoop stresses varies from top to bottom, where at bottom the hoop stress is maximum and the top the hoop stress is minimum, that is almost zero. So at a different level, at 2.3 meter, at 1 point, so at three different levels, we have calculated the hoop tension and the is reinforcement for hoop tension. So as per that reinforcement, we have curtailed at each and every level. So the first level is a 2 by 3, 1.3, then top is 0. So this 2 by 3 and 1 by 3 is basically, as per the pressure, a diagram of your hoop stress is vertical, that is triangular. So the distribution of pressure will be at 1 by 3 from bottom, then 2 by 3, then 0. The division is 1 by 3, 2 by 3 and 3 by 3. 3 by 3 is top, matlab 0. So this is your curtailed reinforcement. As the hoop stresses has been revised, as per this hoop stresses, these are the values of reinforcement. As per these areas, the spacing at that level is provided. So the maximum spacing criteria is it should not exceed the spacing 3 times into thickness of your vertical wall. So 3 times into 160 is 480. So these spacings are under check. So the spacing provided is okay as per the maximum spacing criteria. Now let's talk about the vertical reinforcement, that is the outer face. So the outer face reinforcement, it is because it is resting on ground, so there is no earth pressure acting on the outer surface, so the minimum reinforcement criteria will suffice the design. So the minimum reinforcement criteria is we have to provide a minimum reinforcement of 0.24%, that is equals to AST minimum 384. So we are providing 10 mm dia bar, so the area of one at single 10 mm dia bar is 78.54. we are considering, again we always keep in mind that for design of slab, for design of beam, for design, if the width is not mentioned, specific width is not there, like if your width is 4 meter, 5 meter, we are not designing for 4 meter and 5 meter, we are considering a 1 meter strip width. So the 1 meter strip width we are taking at 1000 mm divided by your total AST. So the spacing is coming around 204 mm center to center, so we have provided 200 mm center to center. Now I think the design is over, we'll be talking about the tank floor. Since the floor is the slab is resting on ground, we have a proper support throughout the slab. So the design will be based on your minimum reinforcement and the thickness. Minimum reinforcement in your bottom slab is 0.3%, which is provided as 0.3%. The thickness of slab is assumed as 150 mm 8 mm diameter bar at 200 center is provided in both the direction. So this is the reinforcement of your bottom slab. So now we have the reinforcement and the design of your vertical wall, the design of your floor wall. The top part of your water tank is open, so it is the top slab has not been designed in this problem. This is just a very basic problem we need to have a brief idea about the design of water tank. So let's move to the detailing part. So since we have this hoop stresses, I've said you the hoop, as per the hoop stresses is varying maximum here and minimum here. So you can see the 16 mm dia bar spacing. At bottom it is 140, then again at this is 1 by 3, which is 16 at 200, then this is 2 by 3 height, 16 at 350, and this is at top. Top, we don't need to provide the hoop stress, the hoop reinforcement, so minimum reinforcement is required. This is your outer face reinforcement because we don't have any earth pressure acting from this. So this is as per your minimum reinforcement criteria, which is 0.24%. The thickness of your vertical wall is 160 mm. Again, now let's talk about this bottom slab. So bottom slab 150 mm thick, 8 mm dia bar at 200 center to center both ways. So we are making a cage of 8 mm dia bar at 200 center to center. So this was your the section of your cross section of your retaining wall. Now this is the plan of your retaining wall. This is a water tank. Sorry, this I said retaining wall. This is not a retaining wall. This is a water tank. So these bars are your hoop stresses, because the hoop stresses are from this side, acting from this side. So hoop stresses, and the outer is the minimum. So hoop tension bar is 16 mm. This is a plan at base. If you are taking the plan at top, then this 16 at 400 center. At bottom we have maximum hoop tension, that's why 16 at 140 center. Here look, this at bottom 16 at 140, and at top 400 at 16 mm at 400. So this was your reinforcement detail in plan and in elevation. So hope this water tank, this was very simple design problem on circular water tank. The basic theory behind a water tank has also been discussed in this problems. In the next video, in the next lecture, I'll be designing a more water tank, circular with rigid base, circular rectangular water tank. So keep watching our videos, keep liking our videos. If you have any queries, any doubt, you can come to us through our comments. And if you, in case you can, you if you want these PPTs, then you can mail to us. You can comment with your mail ID. We will try to send you the PPTs. We can share our PPTs with you guys. So thank you. Have a nice day. Take care. Goodbye.